sons of the prophet were brave men and bold, and quite unaccustomed to fear. But the bravest by far in the ranks of the Shah was Abdul Abulbul Amir. Now the heroes were plenty and well known to fame in the troops that were led by the Czar. And the bravest of these was a man by the name of Ivan Skavinsky Skavar. One day this bold Russian had shouldered his gun and donned his most truculent sneer. Downtown he did go, where he trod on the toe of Abdul Abulbul Amir. Young man, quoth Abdul, has life grown so dull that you wish to end your career? Vile infidel, no, you have trod on the toe of Abdul Abulbul Amir. Said Ivan, my friend, your remarks in the end will avail you but little, I fear. For you ne'er will survive to repeat them alive, Mr. Abdul Abulbul Amir. So take your last look at sunshine and brook, and send your regrets to the Czar. For by this I imply you are going to die, Count Ivan Skavinsky Skavar. And this bold Mameluke drew his trusty skibook with a cry of Allah Akbar. And with murderous intent he ferociously went for Ivan Skavinsky Skavar. They fought all that night 'neath the pale yellow moon. The din it was heard from afar, and huge multitudes came, so great was the fame of Abdul and Ivan Skavar. As Abdul's long knife was extracting the life, in fact he was shouting huzzah. He felt himself struck by that wily Kalmuck, Count Ivan Skavinsky Skavar. The Sultan drove by in his red-breasted fly, expecting the victor to cheer. But he only drew nigh to hear the last sigh of Abdul Abulbul Amir. Tsar Petrovich, too, in his spectacles blue, rode up in his new crested car. He arrived just in time to exchange a last line with Ivan Skavinsky Skavar. There the tomb rises up where the blue Danube rose, engraved there in characters clear. Our stranger, when passing, oh, pray for the soul of Abdul Abulbul Amir. A Muscovite maiden her lone vigil keeps neath the light of the pale polar star. And the name that she murmurs so oft as she weeps is Ivan Skavinsky Skavar.